Hello, my name is Angelo Deere with Freedom Mobile Living. Welcome to my video today, and the topic of it is my review on No Man's Land. Well, that being said, I decided to watch the movie. I mean, I was intrigued by it because of the title Nomadland. Now, I don't know, have you seen the Nomadland? If you did, comment below and let me know that you've seen it. And then if you didn't like it or anything, give me a reason why. Well, I have. I've seen it, and after watching it, I had very mixed reviews, positive and negatives, but some of it was insulting and offending to me, especially me being a nomad. If you stay tuned, I will explain what I actually mean by that. Now, for your best advice, right here, for the best advice on how to reduce your debt and create remote income while living in a vehicle. Now, that could be either a car, an SUV, a van, a trailer, or an RV, regardless of what it is. Subscribe below and hit the notification bell so you'll be alerted of every new video I come out with. I have over 37 years business experience creating income. And just in the last 5 years did I start devoting that time to producing remote income, where you can make money on your terms when and where you want. Now, when I first heard about the movie and I seen the name of it, No Man's Land, the first thing I thought was it has to be, especially with the pandemic happening in 2020, I thought the movie's got to be about the surge in the growth of people getting into a situation where they're in a car, SUV, or a van, or an RV, or trailer. I mean, we've had an explosion of people buying those units, becoming remote because their job went remote, and decided to even take their children and their wife, or the couple, or the single, they're all on the road. So there's been a massive explosion of people doing this mobile living thing. So it's not something that is new. It's been going on since the 70s. The only difference is we had carpet in our vehicles and we didn't have the finer things we have today because of technology. So, but that's what we did, and that's what we were really accustomed to doing. And then came into the pandemic and people being fearful of the rat race, of the lies that have been told to them throughout the years as they were growing up. They decided, hey, wait a minute, I don't have to wait till I retire to experience happiness in the here and now. I can do that now. And so then it had an explosion and we had so many people decided to go into that lifestyle. So that opened up the floodgates of people telling you, the people that have had more experience, to tell you how to do that. And then you can minimize your risk, you can maximize your safety, and you can increase your security while you're doing it. I really thought the movie was about positive things before I watched it. And then I went ahead and watched it. And when was I wrong? I was like not 100% wrong. I was 1,000% wrong. It was dark. It was slow moving. It was bleak. It reminded me a little bit like a Tim Burton movie. There are things in it that did excite me because it was so bleak. It didn't take a lot to get things to excite you. I thought overall the movie was good if you just do it based on a storyline. That's why I've always said that the title of the movie doesn't match the story. So it should be Homelessness Land rather than Nomad Land. And then the movie Nomad Land, it depicted one person's life. That's it. Only one person, fictitious, but one person's life of what they experience. So there's a lot of things, some misinformation. It's almost like somebody becoming a nomad and all of a sudden jumping into the job of Amazon. Well, a lot of them don't know those different jobs. So how they're going to do it? Before she even set off, she would have had some kind of plan on how to get a job. But that's where the fiction takes over in the story. And as far as the fiction part of it, and as far as the directing and the producing, I thought it was A+. I really enjoyed it. I didn't enjoy that the name kind of misguided the picture. And that's probably why the picture got so much notoriety from prior to being released, is because of the name of it. People were expecting a No Man Land type of community. They didn't realize they were going to pick one facet of it, and really it was a homeless person, but depict one facet of it, and then all the other nomads out there, they can be insulted or feel bad about it because that's in no way how they are. It's almost like me when I lived in the sticks of bricks. I really haven't changed who I am. So if I'm dirty, if I don't bathe all the time, I'd be doing that if I was in the sticks and bricks. But I chose to take whatever I am in the sticks and bricks, bring it into the world of mobile living. And that way my bedroom is right there. That's it. My bedroom is the vehicle. And then my living room, my den, everything else is out here. Of course, you know, this is sand. So one reason why I don't like boondocking or camping is because I'm not into dirt. I don't like all the sand, so that's why I have to kind of plan it when I do it. I don't like doing it all the time. So right now I'm in the outskirts of town, so I'm a blacktop, so most of my day is on the blacktop. I'm out there making money and grinding, trying to make money on the ride share and then also on the deliveries. And then I sleep within the city. Normally, I sleep within parked streets is my normal spot, but I do go to other places, especially if I stay within the city. I'm going to look at 3 to 4 spots where I can sleep at, and then I'll change them up periodically. I never sleep in the same spot, and I never play where I sleep. So if I go to sleep somewhere, that's exactly what it is. It's just a sleeping spot. My playing spots are elsewhere and else other div. And I'll get more into that in future videos. So how do I spend my day? One thing nice is to keep busy. So the remote work does that for me. A lot of times I will do a little bit extra. So I'll do maybe 2 platforms and then I'll throw a third one in there just to kind of play with it. But a lot of times when I'm doing it, it's not only because of money, but it gives me idle time as far as eating up some of my dead time, my loneliness that everybody speaks about. I don't have that loneliness. Because of that movie, is one thing that's really, really bothers me. A lot of the world will stereotype nomads. They'll look at people in that movie or the nomads in that movie, and because they live that type of nomad class of life, they'll assume everybody lives that way as well. They have no clue of the nomad like myself, or the nomad with a family, or the single or the couples out there. There are some nomads out there, they're exploring and traveling and doing that, and there's other people are doing it on just enjoying life and living off pennies, like paradise for pennies. Man, honorable, you know, at least they have the happiness, the here and now, and that's so important for us to do that. Nomad. Well, it's real simple. Homelessness is something that you're forced into doing it. If I'm a nomad and make a conscious decision, it's something I want to do rather than something forced in. So a lot of the people in that no man land, in the movie itself, and the people that were not actors, but they were extras and they were real nomads, majority of them in that circle are the ones that are in dire need. They're the ones that are suffering. They don't have enough income in order to support the lifestyle. And that's where they turn to people like Bob Wells. And Bob Wells is good because it's almost like in a sticks and bricks era. It's almost like helping a homeless person out in that type of situation. In the case of Nomad Land, Fern, what happened, her and her husband lost their jobs during that era in 2008. But when that happened, they became homeless. A better title for it would be Homelessness Land. If we could name it Homelessness Land, then it depicts truth. And that way, it doesn't get really blurred as far as fact and fiction of the movie. Because that's really, I think, what happens is it ends up becoming a little bit blurred on the way we look at it because of the way it depicted. It really didn't show the truth of everything. If that's the case, when she became a nomad or chose to be a nomad, right? She was had a job, she lost a job, and she was looking for another job, and she couldn't find it. And then we've seen how it was cold out, and the jobs were scarce. But what nomad in a van is going to be living in a condition such as that? Because majority of nomads, they go where the sun's at. So they never really showed any how she was keeping herself warm. But in a normal real life situation, she couldn't have dealt with the cold or didn't want to deal with the cold. And so she didn't have to wait for jobs not to be available. She would have left. So a lot of times I have gone out in the boondocks, but generally I do it within a 3-day clip or something like that. But really, because all my income's made on the road, I'm forced where camping is not a lifestyle that I would even like, because I would really get bored with it. One thing nice about being a nomad or being in mobile living and making my income based on that, the nice thing about it is that when I do get bored, I can convert that into dollars of income. So if I get bored, I can increase the amount of work I put out there driving and equate, it's gonna increase my income for the week. And since I've been a nomad, I've eliminated my overhead. I've paid off a lot of my debt. I still have debt I have to continue to pay off. But I'm consciously looking for profit-centered platforms. I've started already my Ride Local independent platform where I take customers or people that want rides or delivery, and I make them a customer of mine. So anytime they request it, I get them through my Ride Local platform. That is building. I'm excited about it. I can just see what the future is in 2021. It's going to be crazy. But anyhow, I make my money based on that. Now, once I get to a level where I have enough riders or deliveries, then I'll start adding drivers on and inching myself out of driving or doing deliveries and operating the business based on what I wanted to from the beginning. And with that platform of Ride Local, anybody can do it. It takes a commitment. It's not something that's easy. It's something that you build over time. So if you like rideshare or if you like doing deliveries, you enjoy doing that. That's important because then you can build your own platform and get to a point where nobody can dictate anything to you and you can live life on your terms.